it's Candus, and in today's QuickBooks tips and tricks, I want to teach you how to read your report. So you'll hear me oftentimes talk about reports, why they're so important, understanding them to make business decisions. So recently I was asked a question about the balance sheet. And I think oftentimes it's misunderstood because people just don't get what the purpose of the balance sheet is or what even belongs on the balance sheet. They're always like, why is it not over here? How do I find it? What goes there? So today I want to teach you what actually goes on the balance sheet so that when you're looking for it, you can find it. Again, to make business decisions. So come look over my shoulder and I'll teach you how. All right, let's get in and I will show you all about the balance sheet. So first I'm going to teach you how to pull up the balance sheet, and then we are going to talk about the different things that belong in each of the areas. So the first thing you're going to do to pull up the balance sheet is you're going to go under reports, company and financial, and you will see balance sheet standard. We're going to select that. And the first thing to know about the balance sheet is it represents a company's financial position at a specific date. So what that basically means is it's a snapshot of whatever date you pick of what happened up to that date. So this one is as of December 15th. If you changed it to December 31st, it would change, but it's as of that moment. A profit and loss, statement of cash flow, they are from one time frame to another. And so it's what happened throughout that span. A balance sheet is everything that happened up to the moment you run it. So hopefully that is clear. So the first area on a balance sheet is the assets. And there are a lot of different types of assets, but assets are the things that you own or things you basically acquired through transactions that you've done. In other words, your checking account has increased through services that you have provided. So there's a lot of different types of assets. There are like checking and savings, or what's considered current assets. And you have accounts receivable under current assets. So all your different checking accounts, savings accounts, accounts receivable. And then you have what's called other current assets. And other current assets are things that are going to be used up within the year. So prepaid insurance, undeposited funds, those kinds of things. Then you have fixed assets. These are all the different types of assets. And fixed assets are usually significant purchases like vehicles, land, buildings, those kinds of things. So those are all your different types of assets. And then in this example, I'm going to simplify these so it's easier to look at. So basically what it comes down to is you have, in this one, we have current assets, fixed assets, part of the current assets of the bank accounts as well. Then that equals the $162,852.85. Then you have your liabilities, which your liabilities are going to be like your accounts payable, any credit cards you have. You'll notice that's what these are, accounts payable, credit cards, and then you have other current liabilities. And those are the things that you owe in less than a year. In other words, those are like your payroll liabilities, your sales tax, those kinds of things. And then you get your long-term liabilities that you're gonna, that's gonna be longer than a year, your property loans or different kinds of loans that you have, bank loans. Those are long-term. So those are all your different types of liabilities. Then you come down and you have your equity. And your equity has to do with the amount of money you either put into your business as in capital, the amount of money you took out in draws if you're a sole proprietor, and then so that's what this is. It's like the opening balance, the draws that they've taken out, and then the retained earnings, and then from year to year, and then the current net income of the current year. What this is basically telling you is that your assets equal the same thing, and your liabilities and your equity equal your assets. So see how this is 162 and this is 162? These equal each other. Another way to say that is your owner's equity equals your assets minus your liabilities. So either way you do it, it's the same thing. So your assets are things that you have, liquid, basically cash and properties and that type of stuff, minus your loan, the people you owe or your creditors, gives you your equity, or the amount of money that your business is worth. So what this does is it gives, if you were going to go out and get a loan, it gives your bank a snapshot of what is happening within your business. How liquid are you? How much do you owe, and how much equity do you have in your business at the time that this was created? Now, a lot of people get confused when they're looking at the profit and loss. They think that the money that they take out is a draw, meaning they just took cash right out of their business, should show up on the profit loss. They think of it as a business expense. It's actually not a business expense. It is taking money out of your equity or money away from your business. So another way to know where to put different types of items on your balance sheet is to go up under lists, chart of accounts. All of these are a type of a chart of account. So to the right here, you'll see, you know, current asset, accounts receivable, fixed assets, and all that kind of stuff. Well, if you are like, I have no idea which one it belongs in, if you go down to account and click new, as you're adding different accounts, if you go over here and you click fixed major asset, it'll tell you what that is. It's a significant item, and it's going to be useful for more than 1 year. And if you're going to use a bank account, that's obviously a bank. If you have a loan, it's a loan. Credit cards, equity, it tells you what the equity is. And then other ones are down here. So this is where a current asset would be, other asset, your long-term loans, and those kinds of things. But just know that really the balance sheet fills in the gaps for a profit and loss statement. So the profit and loss shows your income minus your expenses. And then that shows up here. The difference, your actual net income shows up here. But what the balance sheet gives you is what amount of assets do you have, meaning how much cash do you have in the bank at this moment? What other kinds of, you know, loans or different things do you have, which is your liabilities? Who do you owe? And then how much do you have in your, how much is your business basically worth? What is your equity in your business? So I hope that has been beneficial for you. If you have any more questions about understanding the balance sheet, feel free to contact me. It really is just a snapshot of the overall picture of your business, the health, so to speak, of your business. Have an amazing day. Don't forget, if you enjoyed this video, please share it. And if you'd like to get more videos, I do these tips and tricks weekly. Feel free to subscribe. And Confidence with QuickBooks is now available. It is my online course. If you're wanting to really understand QuickBooks in a simple way from an entrepreneur's point of view, which is what I am, feel free to go to confidencewithquickbooks.com and check it out. Have a great day. Talk to you guys next week. Bye.